A general journey in photogrammetry. How to take photos. If you want to obtain a good reality-based 3D model using photogrammetry, you first have to take photos. If you want to know more about photogrammetry, you can have a look at the video about what is photogrammetry. Let's now consider how photos must be. They must have good image quality, be shot from different points, frame as much of the object as possible, not be too many or too few, and overlap with each other. To ensure a good overlap, try to keep in mind what you framed in the previous photo. Move aside and frame the object again, making sure that more than half of what you saw in the previous photo is captured again in this one. If you circle the object, the coverage is usually much higher. According to the shape and the size of the object we want to digitize, we can move in different ways, depending on whether if it's possible to rotate around it, or it is more suitable to shift in front of it. In any case, the first rule is to be systematic and neat. For a standalone object, take the photos pointing to the object, circling it and shooting from many angles. Make sure that every photo frames at least half of the previous one. It's better to make sure that you have a common coverage of about 80%. Do not rotate the object, but move around it yourself. You usually need more than one lap around the object, varying the height from which you take the photos. Some photos must record also the top of the object. In the end, you will have recorded all parts of the object in a repetitive way, with an orderly array of photos. Photogrammetry permits the reconstruction of objects of any shapes and size. For a really long object, point the camera in the direction of the object and shoot sliding yourself to one side. If you are in front of a building, take one step sideways at a time. If you are working with a small object, make smaller moves. Pay attention to ensure a good overlap between consecutive images and, if possible, repeat more strips at different heights. When you complete your first strip of photos in front of the object, do another one by tilting the camera to your left, and then another, tilting your camera to your right. In this way, the entire surface will be recorded. Pay attention to the corners. Take multiple photos moving around them to complete your project. Consider that for big projects, as a building or a big statue as well. A lot of photos are needed. Being systematic and neat helps to manage big projects. Remember that you should take them from different point of view, also considering the eye. Your project will probably fail, or your model won't be pleasing if you take photos in an incorrect way, or without a good overlap between images. Do not rotate the camera while standing still. The 3D reconstruction process requires photos taken from various points of view. Note that it's the opposite of stitching photos for the process of creating panoramas. The scene setup must take into consideration the shape and size of the object to be digitized. We will take a different approach when dealing with a small object, where we will usually be indoors. With a big object like a building facade, otherwise, we will normally be outdoors. When working indoors, it is usually possible to better control the scene setup. Free up some space all around the object. If you put it on a table, it will be more comfortable to move around it. Make sure it is stable and, if necessary, use some support to fix it properly. To plan the point of view from where you take photos, you can make small signs with chalk or adhesive tape. Prepare also a measuring tape. It will make a difference in your model, as we shall see in a moment. Check the lighting. Photos are made by light, so it's crucial to properly set up the lighting of the scene to be captured. The best light is natural light, but you can also use lamps, pointing them, not on the object, avoiding hard shadows as much as possible. To record accurately textures, you should consider white balancing on your camera. In the next video, we'll provide more photographic tips for taking excellent photos to digitize objects, both inside and outside. The very last tip is to pay attention to focusing well the object with respect to its background. When working outside, as in front of a building, for example, it is more difficult to control light conditions. Also, reaching higher points of view can be a struggle. The easier solution can be provided by a photographic tripod, but sometimes high stairs and scaffoldings are required. Drones offer a big opportunity to reach any points of view, but professional skills and appropriate knowledge of local regulation are needed. For big objects, direct measurements of distances is usually not enough for a good metric control of the project. So, control points measured by total station are generally employed. Plan your scanning route. So, for planning your scanning route, consider the shape and the size of the object and plan how to move and to take pictures with respect to it. Make a sign from where you begin to take photos. It will help you stay on track. Make also some signs where you will shoot. Or, in the case of small objects, you can print a sheet of paper with angular references. Avoid lighting changes. Take the photos, trying to move along the path you planned, shooting from different angles. Hold the camera firmly and frame the object filling your screen. You can also use a small tripod or a selfie stick. A reality-based 3D model should be a faithful reproduction of the original. But how close is the copy respect to the original? Some aspects can be replicated very well, such as shape, color, size. A rigorous approach can estimate how accurate a 3D model is. But this is not the primary goal of this video. We define here a model as accurate, as close as it's to the original. Unscaled models can satisfy some purposes. But we wish to focus on metric models that are models in scale, so that it is possible to measure their size or the size of some parts, and it is possible to express orthogonal views to document the original object properly. Keep in mind that if you want your model to be in real scale, you must add some more information to your project. For small objects, a few distances are enough to obtain a good model. So, when you set up the scene, measure at least a couple of distances between well-recognizable points. It can be helpful to fix on the object, or better around it, some small targets, and measure the distances between their centers. If possible, consider not fixing the target only on the table or the object support, but also on some vertical element. Many well-done photos with order and method and some distances are everything you need to get effective models when using low-cost equipment. Photogrammetry is a highly flexible technique. The approach proposed here can profitably apply to a multitude of objects, ranging from small artifacts to large buildings. Keep in mind that, in the latter case, the measurements of only a few distances is not sufficient to guarantee an adequate accuracy of the model. Instead, it is necessary to provide topographic measurements of some control points. So, you can get a good model with a limited number of good measurements and good photographic images.